All right, Tornike has two questions, and his first one was, what's the last photo you took? Hey guys, welcome back, or if this is your first time here, my name is Brandon, and welcome to a place for melodic metal guitarists, trying a new view, a new angle. We'll just see if you guys like this or if you like the straight on view. But I thought this was kind of neat. It's a dynamic shot. But anyway, first, before we get started in today's Q&A, I just want to say I am blessed to have you guys, to just have you guys there as a community. I was earlier today chatting with one of my buddies, one of my fans from YouTube. And I'll just go ahead and say his name, Brandon Adams. You know, he was just talking about how much he enjoyed, you know, my music and stuff. And just complimenting me and everything, and it's just, it made me really sit and reflect and think, wow, it's just amazing that you guys all across the world actually want to watch me on YouTube. And before I forget, I need to tell you guys that I have added, per the request of one individual, the ability where you can submit your own captions. Like if you want to caption my video in another language, then you can now do that. So if that's something that any of you guys want to do, you can go back and caption a lot of my videos. I probably would recommend starting with the more popular videos first, maybe the 15 Bad Habits, because that's the one, the Breaking Bad Habits is the most popular video that's going on right now. But the point of that is possibly people being able to, even in other countries that don't speak English, to be able to read in their own native language, because only 40% of you now are in the US who are watching my videos, 60% are outside the USA. So the more people that we can reach, the better. Alrighty, well, our first few questions comes from PS. He's one of my patrons. I know his real name, but he goes by these initials. He says, as a fellow beard cultivator, do you have any conditioner, or do you use any conditioner on your beard? I don't, actually. I typically just wash it with soap. I mean, maybe sometimes I'll shampoo it, but nope, I don't use anything special on my beard. Maybe I should. I will say that anytime I ever have, it always feels nice and fluffy. His other question that he had was, have you ever attempted to repaint a guitar? I bought one off of eBay for 15, I don't know what that is, euros or pounds. I'm sorry, I'm US dollars here. I don't know what that is. I have never done that. This guy I follow, Leo, I'll put it up in as a card. He did a video on that, and you can check that out if you guys are interested in that kind of a thing. I've never attempted it. I don't think I'd ever want to, just because I'm such a perfectionist that any mistake I do, it would just bug me forever. So Francesco, he asks me, what classic music pieces would you say are the most fun to learn on the guitar? Now, I was originally reading this to myself as classical music pieces, but maybe that's not what he means. Maybe he's talking about classic. But let's just say he's asking classical music pieces. If that's the case, anything by Bach would probably be the funnest thing, because he just got such a really cool sound that you could make into metal style very easily, like a lot of people do. So if you're talking about actual classic music pieces, like Elvis is classic, I have no idea. Not my genre, so I have no idea what that would be, if that's not what you meant. Anyway, S.A. says, what about your favorite metal bands of all time? And I do have a video for that, actually. You can check that out in the card. Check out that video, man, and anybody else that's looking for that information. Allie Jr. asks, do you like Judas Priest? And the answer is no, I've never got into them before. I don't really know anything about them, but sorry, I've never. But then again, you guys did get me into Dream Theater, and I really am enjoying that. I went ahead and bought Metropolis Part 2, I believe it was. There was a lot of people that recommended that album, and everybody says that, like, that's the best that Dream Theater ever got. Like, that's the prime. So I bought it, and I've been listening to it. It's really cool. I'm almost done with it, and quite an adventure. I really like it. Joshua L., he asks me, do you like playing rhythm or lead parts more? And that really depends. I guess if you had to pin me down for an answer, I would say rhythms. And that comes down to just what I'm confident in. Like, so for example, if you found me in a guitar center, it would be with the volume very low, just as low as possible, and it would be rhythms. Because I know that if I play leads, I don't have as much skill. And I know people will be like, what are you talking about? Okay, hear me out. I don't play leads very well by myself. I need something else to play to, and I don't improvise well either. So with rhythms, it's a lot easier to cover up mistakes, even though it's, I guess, more fun to play leads, but that's when I'm by myself. And he had another question Joshua asked. Also, do you have thoughts on Christian metal band War of Ages? I think they're pretty cool. I've got a couple of their albums. It's not one of those bands that I listen to a lot, but you know, I have listened to them before, and they're okay. I'll give them a 7 out of 10 for my preference. All right, Tornike has two questions, and his first one was, what's the last photo you took? Okay, well, if you don't count the screenshots that I did of people's questions and people's recommendations, then I guess it would be my church bulletin's announcements page. But I'm not going to show you that because there's some information on there that's specific to our church group, so I don't think it's necessary to show you that. So I guess the follow-up picture for that would be in my business casual self. It's a self-portrait, and it is basically just me right after my work. And then he asks, what's the most expensive thing that you've broken? Okay, I've got to say that I thought about this question because, of course, I saw this question ahead of time. The only thing that just kept coming up in my mind over the years has been my car, I guess, because it's a 2001 Oldsmobile Alero, and over time, it is my first car, by the way. With used cars, there's a lot of upkeep. Yeah, technically, I'm breaking it because basically destroying because I'm driving it. Okay, well, I guess that's all the questions for today. Thank you guys who are still watching to the very end, and don't forget that this Saturday, I am releasing my music video, Breaking Point, just June the 3rd, and then the following Wednesday, June the 7th, I will have the bloopers, behind the scenes stuff, all that good stuff, and I will see you guys next Saturday. Y'all have a great one.